Hey guys, it's Peter from Lost Angle. Today we're going to try something new. We're going to do what I call fly casting shorts. In other words, what I'm going to try to do is look at different casting problems people have and then how we can correct them. If you guys have watched my videos a while, you know I like big streamers. I like big, bulky flies. And sometimes those can be a real pain to cast. So what you got to have to worry about is a rapid change in direction. So when you're casting a heavy fly like a big flouser or a big weighted deceiver, or just a big air-resistant deer fly, what you want to do is to avoid a hinging of the line. You can correct that with different things like leader and all that, but eventually it's going to come down to your casting stroke. This is how we're always taught to cast. And what I'm going to use to illustrate this is Reddington Form practice fly rod. I hope it's easy to see. We're taught to come back and forth overhead loops, nice, tight, even loops. But the problem with that is when we're coming back and forth with our even loops on that big wind-resistant fly, it starts to hinge. And what you end up doing is what we call a duck and chuck. Because as you're coming forward with that fly, that weighted or air-resistant fly is coming back towards the back of your head as fast as it can. So you end up with the duck and the chuck, right? So we're going to show you how to avoid that. One of the first things you can do is slow down your casting stroke. Give the time for the line to fully unload going backwards and forwards. Because any time that you don't let that line fully unload, that's when the hinging really starts. You gotta let it be fully loaded before you come forward. Now that's a nice easy way to do it, but it does take a lot of practice. And that can come back to bite you in the butt because some flies are just too big and just too weighted for that to work well. So we often overcompensate by using big 10 weight rods or whatever. Here's another way you can do it. What I'm going to show you is called oval style cast or Belgian style cast. What happens is, it's like a combination sidearm cast, overhand cast. I'm going to come back sidearm, and I'm going to come forward, overhand. So back, forward, back, forward, back, forward. And what that does is it eliminates that rapid change in direction. This right here will help you to catch more fish more efficiently by casting those bigger, more air-resistant flies a lot easier. Hope this helps.